Hi guys, this is Vaish from Vaish IAS, and we are going to continue the prelims 2017 paper. We have done up to 75 questions, so let's do the last part, which is having question number 76 to 100. Okay, so polity: in the election for Lok Sabha or state assembly, the winning candidate must get at least 50% of the votes polled to be declared elected. So it's a totally wrong statement, because we know in India even 20% 30% votes you get, but if it's the highest, you will be declared elected. Okay, first past the post system. To check that knowledge only, they ask the statement. So one is wrong. According to the provisions laid down in the Constitution of India, in Lok Sabha, the speaker post goes to the majority party and the deputy speaker goes to the opposition party. This actually is happening in India, but it's not laid down in the Constitution. Okay, it's just by convention or by the process which is happening or followed throughout the years, it is being followed. So option 2 is also wrong. So 1 and 2, both incorrect. Question number 77, which are the following have occurred in India after its liberation of economic policy in 1991? So you know the globalization, privatization, liberalization, that is LPG reforms happened in 1991. So just checking what all happened. So share of agriculture in GDP increased enormously, share of India's exports in world trade increased, FDI's inflows increased, India's foreign exchange reserve increased enormously. So just checking in different factors, very easy question, because agriculture, you know, it actually declined after that, because we focused on more of industrialization, or you can tell liberal policies for getting in more fund and all. So one you can eliminate. If you eliminate one itself, option A and option D is gone. Okay, and if you see B and C, 2, 3 both are there, so 2 and 3 automatically become correct. That is, Indian export also increased, FDI also increased. Now only confusion is between the fourth statement, that is India's foreign exchange reserves increased enormously. So here, even though it is an extreme word, it is actually true, because India was in that much big crisis, that is why these reforms had to be implemented, and so the foreign exchange now has increased enormously. We know now we have huge foreign reserves compared to 1991. So this is actually true. So 2, 3, 4, option B, 77. 78 is actually only if you have read about it, you will know the somatic cell nuclear transfer technology. Just asking the application of it. Okay, so if you have read it, it's related to cloning. Okay, at least that word, if you remember, one choice is there: reproductive cloning of animals. Okay, somatic cell nuclear transfer technology. So there is nothing much to see other than this. These are these kind of things happen every year. 2016-17 current affairs and science and technology also, if you are reading very sincerely, you would cover many such things, and UPSC will definitely pick up a question also from there. So it is option C. 79, which is NPCI, very one of the easiest question. NPCI of India, NPCI helps in promoting the financial inclusion. Okay, very easy statement, is correct. NPCI has launched the RuPay. Okay, RuPay, UPI, Beam, lot of things. NPCI, RuPay is actually what? It is actually the payment gateway. Like we have the MasterCard and Visa, Indian version of it is RuPay. Okay, so 1 and 2 both are correct. It's a very easy question. Next is again an easy question, M-Stripes. So M-Stripes is actually an application for tiger maintenance. Okay, tiger reserve maintenance. So maintenance of tiger reserves. This was also there in the news multiple times. So anybody who is a serious aspirant will not make such questions difficult wrong. Okay, so whenever you are confused with any top 10 questions, okay, when you scroll down, if you find totally depressed or something, just start from the bottom. Okay, from 100 onwards, you will see like lot of easy questions are there in the bottom, and somehow try to make the 55 questions right. If you are in one round of reading, if you make 55 questions right now, then surely you will clear that prelims. Okay, don't simply waste time in the other 45 questions. Don't attempt if it's totally blunder, okay, totally blank to you. Just one, there will be still, after 55, I'm telling, there will be still 20 questions where you are doubting between one or two choices. There you can do few attempts. But if in one round of reading, if you did only 35 or 40 questions, then it's little tougher. Then you have to very seriously work on that other 20 questions where you are having doubt, and you have to make sure that all that 20 you make it right. So in total, 55 to 60 questions is what we should aim without the negative. Okay, like suppose you make 60 right, but if you make 40 wrong, then your whatever you have gained also will go away. So please try to make 55 questions right. That should be your aim for prelims. Don't try to be a topper in prelims, or don't try to be 100 out of 100 in prelims, because we need it just for getting into the mains. Okay, because we'll be very good in mains, but because unfortunately these UPSC pattern is going on changing in prelims, we are not able to reach there. So try to make sure, like 2018 prelims, we all clear. Okay, everybody who is watching this video, I want you to clear 2018 prelims. Okay, next one, 81. What is are the most likely advantages of implementing GST? So GST next year also definitely 2-3 questions will come. So So it will replace multiple taxes collected by multiple authorities and will thus create a single market in India. Obviously, that is why GST has been brought. So one is true. It will drastically reduce the current account deficit of India. That is a false statement. No need to read the rest itself, because current account deficit is something else. Okay, GST is for some other purpose, for indirect tax regime only. So 2 is wrong. 3, it will enormously increase the growth and size of economy of India and will enable it to overtake China in the near future. This is a very ambitious statement, you can call, because China's GDP is somewhere else and India's GDP is somewhere down. Okay, to reach China in near future, the last part of statement alone, you can tell it is wrong statement. Okay, it will obviously increase the size of economy. India will grow. It's being seen also. So, but overtaking China in near future, that is wrong. Okay, so 3 is wrong, 2 is wrong. So option A, 1 only, 81 82. Again, European Union, this is the third question, I think. Broad-based trade and investment agreement, which is not yet ratified, but it is still in talks since, I think, many years. Okay, 15-16 rounds of talks have been already happened, but still it is not come into place. So European Union and India, the agreement or the trade relation, you can tell, it is called Broad-Based Trade and Investment Agreement, BTIA. Like this, many FTAs are happening across the world, okay, but this has a particular name, that is why question has been framed. Okay, consider the following statements. India has ratified the, okay, TFA. This was a very interesting question, very easy question if you are a person who reads current affairs daily, okay, because when we are preparing for 2017 exam, which was in June, obviously you will be reading current affairs of January, February, March and all, and you would have read the news like TFA came into existence only in February 2017. That is just 2-3 months before you gave your prelims. This was a news item. So if you have read that thing, this third choice you could have eliminated, because it's purposely testing that particular knowledge only. Have you read the current affairs just 2-3 months before your exam? That is what they are testing through this question. Leave all the other things. If you knew that thing, 3 you could have eliminated from BCD, and option A is the right answer. Okay, because India ratified the trade facilitation agreement, maybe you are in doubt. The Bali ministerial summit, maybe you don't know whether it's Doha or Bali or any other Cancun or any other region where WTO summit happened. But this thing, that is why I told current affairs, every day you study anything or not, please read the Hindu and read the current affair material, whichever you're reading, whether it's IAS Baba site or any other coaching material, whatever, daily, whatever happens, 6 or 7 news only will happen every day. That you should be thorough, even today, tomorrow, till your June, and after that also, till you become an IAS officer. After that also, anyway, you need to know the news, but you should be thorough with the current affairs. Okay, so this is A, 1 and 2. Now, Chabahar Port, again, multiple types of news. Next year, I think, question will come about the CPEC, okay, the Pakistan-China corridor, okay. So read about that. So India's trade, what will happen? Okay, what is the importance of Chabahar Port? That is what is asked. Very easy question. So India's trade with African country will announce. So Africa, nothing to do with this. India's relation with oil producing Arab, again, nothing to do with. Because Chabahar Port, we know Iran, it was like in media for many months. And India will not depend on Pakistan for access to Asia, access to Afghanistan and Central Asia. So we know this thing. Dalaram Saranj highway is being created in Afghanistan. So India can reach directly to Iran, and then from Iran it can go to Afghanistan. So Pakistan can be bypassed. So that is the main purpose. So option C is the right answer. Option D, if you see, it's again something related to pipeline, gas pipeline. Okay, that is a different thing. And Tapi pipeline is there, that's a totally different thing. So 84 is C. 85. In India, it is legally mandatory for which of the following to report on cyber security incidents. This is just common sense checking what all cyber security is needed, okay, for which all legally it is mandatory. So service provider, obviously you know the telecom providers and all, but then data centers, then body corporate bodies also, it will be required. You will be just, it's like guessing very simple things. Service provider will be needed, body corporate will be needed. So 1 and 3 will be there. So such a choice, only 1, 2, 3 is there, okay. So data center, if you don't know also, corporate bodies and the service provider, obviously there will be legal mandatory things for cyber security. So 1, 2 and 3 is the right answer. Next one is the controversial question, which is like, anyway, you have to wait for the answer key of what UPSC has in mind. Because right to vote, we all tell like our constitution gives us the right to vote. We have been hearing that in movies also, in stories, in articles, in speeches, everywhere. So constitutional right is what we know, because article 326 tells about adult suffrage. Adult suffrage meaning, if you translate literally, it is everybody about 18 can vote. So clearly article 326 is telling it's a constitutional right. So that is what 90% of the aspirants marked it. But there are other 10% students who are thinking like it is a legal right, because the provisions for voting or the restrictions in voting and all is mentioned in the Representation of People Act 1951, okay, RPA Act. So because the provisions are mentioned here, people are telling no, it's not a constitutional right, it's a legal right. So now we have to wait for UPSC thing to see whether they are telling C as right or D as right. Sometimes they'll put like C comma D. They have done it in the past also. If that's a controversial thing, they'll give marks to both. If you're given C also, D also, okay. Or like I told, if you are very much confused and you have already cleared the cutoff, don't even attempt it, leave it. Okay, don't attempt controversial questions. Okay, but I would say the answer is constitutional right. Okay, 87, ELISA. ELISA was again in news because the LIGO project, you know, LIGO in Washington, in Louisiana, already two things are there. And in India, in Maharashtra, again, Hingoli district in Maharashtra, I think they are again going to form the third LIGO. But these are all ground-based gravitational wave observatory. But European Space Agency, what they're doing is they're trying to put the same thing in the space. Okay, three satellites they'll put in triangle form around the Earth, and then that will observe the gravitational waves. Okay, so that project is called ELISA. So ELISA is B, to detect gravitational waves. This year also a lot of missions are there for NASA. So please know at least the name and the purpose. Okay, I have made a table. One day I will make a video for Science and Technology Current Affairs. That time maybe it will be helpful for you. But you also please make notes. Vidyanjali, again an education related scheme. I think Unnat Bharat Abhiyan is also there. Yeah, next question is again Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. So they are just picking up all the schemes which are in news. Okay, so Vidyanjali scheme, it is, we have to check whether all the statements are correct or not. To enable the famous foreign educational institutions to open their campus in India, this is actually a totally different scheme. It's not Vidyanjali, the name is something else. Then to increase the quality of education provided in government schools by taking help from the private sector and community. This is actually true. Vidyanjali is for someone can volunteer themselves to go and teach in the education of government schools. Okay, that is Vidyanjali. Okay, there's a portal also where you can go and register. So that is true. Two is true. Third one, to encourage voluntary monetary contributions from private individuals and organizations so as to improve the infrastructure facilities for primary and secondary schools. This is not true. There's nothing related to funding and all. It's just about going and teaching. Okay, Vidyanjali. So 88 is 2 only, that is A is the right answer. Unnat Bharat Abhiyan is just asking the objective. So all are like closely related choices. Achieving 100% literacy by promoting collaboration between volunteer organizations. So there is nothing like that. There is no achieving 100% literacy scheme and all. Okay, then connecting institutions of higher education with local communities to address developmental challenges through appropriate technology. So this is one possible answer. Then strengthening India's scientific research institutions in order to make India a scientific and technological power. So this is also not true. This is some other scheme. Scientific, science related lot of projects are there. Even Niti Aayog is doing the Atal Tinkering Labs and all. So that is different thing. Developing human capital by allocating special funds for healthcare and education of rural and urban poor and organizing skill development programs and vocational training. So this is, they are combining lot of other schemes. Okay, skill development they are doing, then giving funds are there, healthcare is there, education. This is not Unnat Bharat Abhiyan. Okay, it may seem it is the answer, but Unnat Bharat Abhiyan is actually for education purpose alone. So education by connecting the higher institute with the local communities. Okay, so that by using technology. So that is 89B. Okay, option B. Question number 90, again polity. Election Commission of India. Okay, it was in news, that is why this is asked. Actually, the Samajwadi Party split up, you know, the cycle symbol and all those things, they were having fights and all. So that problem, that is why this question is asked. Okay, so election body is a 5-member body. It is a totally wrong statement if you know Lakshmikant. It's just a 3-member body. Okay, one chief election commissioner and two election commissioners. Then Union Minister of Home Affairs decides the election schedule. So do you think a minister will decide the election schedules? It is not minister. Okay, it's the election commission who will decide. So that is also wrong. Third one, if you know that too, you have got the answer as option D. Okay, so third one, election commission resolves the disputes related to splits or mergers of the recognized political party. So this is the current affair. Okay, so two things from Lakshmikant and one current affair, they clubbed and made a question. So the answer is 3 only, option D, 90D. 91, in India, if the this is a very interesting question. If a species of tortoise is declared protected under Schedule 1, already Schedule 1 I have explained to you, like it's the most protected animals in India, Schedule 1 to 5, and to 4 is actually protected in the decreasing order, and 5 is actually vermin where you can kill the animal. That's also one question we have done already. Then then Schedule 6 is plants. Okay, that is the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. So they are asking, if tortoise is given Schedule 1 status, what does it mean? Okay, basic thing. So the first choice itself will give you the answer. It enjoys the same level of protection as the tiger. Tiger, you know, the national animal, obviously it will be there in Schedule 1. So that itself is giving you the answer, but you can read the other choices. it no longer exists in the wild. A few individuals are under captive protection and now it is impossible to prevent its extinction. So there is a something story kind of thing they have told. It's wrong. It is endemic to a particular region of India. There is nothing like endemic or something to put there in schedules. Okay, then both B and C stated are correct. So actually B, C, D all are wrong. Okay, so it's a very easy question. 91A. Now 92. Indian judicial review. Okay, again they are just testing your knowledge. Okay, it's not a bookish kind of definition, but just testing your knowledge. What is judicial review? The power of the judiciary to pronounce upon the constitutionality of the laws and executive orders. So whether the laws made by the government are in provision or in accordance with the constitution. Okay, because judiciary is considered as the guardian of the constitution. Okay. President is considered as the, I think, the defender of the constitution or something. There are certain terms like this which is mentioned in Lakshmikant in various chapters. So make a note of similar points like this because UPSC frames questions. So one is that A is actually true. We'll anyway see the B, C, D. Okay. The power of judiciary to question the wisdom of the laws. Okay. If option A was not there, maybe you could have selected this one. Okay. This is also kind of true, but actually it is checking the constitutionality. Then C, the power of the judiciary to review all the legislative enactment before they are presented to the president. Okay, this is not true. This is not. This is also a judicial review only, you can tell, but that is not what is done in the actual passing of the bill. Okay, if the Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha passes it, then it will go to the president. The power of the judiciary to review its own judgment. So judiciary, it keeps on correcting whatever it has already told. If you know Berubari case in 1960 or 66, it was told like preamble is not even a part of constitution. Okay, but later in 1973, I think Keshav Bharati case, it told like we correct that statement and preamble is definitely an integral part of constitution. So that is also happening, but this is not judicial review. Judicial review is the first one, 92A. Okay. Now with reference to Indian freedom struggle, chronology question, every year one question comes, and the good thing is they don't ask very nearby incidents. They'll ask only at least 10 years difference will be there between each of the event. So people don't have to be worried, okay, like which happened next or which happened after this. So it's actually mutiny in Royal Indian Navy, towards independence in 1946 only it happened. Quit India movement happened in 1942. Okay, it's in news, okay, Quit India movement. And then second round table conference, it happened in 1931. Okay, 1930, 31, 32 only, all the three round table conference happened. So it is in the reverse order, 3, 2 and 1. So option C. Okay, all the events, cabinet mission, Wavell plan, Rajagopalachari formula, many things are there. Okay, main events. Just know the years of each of these things. Spectrum I have done in detail. That's the best source for you to learn modern history. Please watch my Spectrum series. Next is again an interesting thing, like based on economic survey or the economic trend, you can tell for the last one decade. Okay, so tax revenue as a percentage of GDP of India has steadily increased in the last decade. So last 10 years, that is 2007 to 17, you can tell the GDP has steadily increased. This is actually true because our economy has been increasing anyway. The GDP will be increasing, so obviously the tax collection also will be increasing. That is something like our salary and all. Our salary will be obviously increasing, right, year by year. So that is correct. Okay, tax revenue as a percentage of GDP has steadily increased. One is correct. Second one, fiscal deficit as a percent of GDP has steadily increased. That means deficit is increasing, but that is wrong. If you know, after the Modi government has come, fiscal deficit has actually reduced one or two times. Okay, so it's not steadily increased from 2007 to 2017. So this is false. So option A, 94A, one only. Last five questions. Again, a easy question if you follow current affairs. The Asiatic lions in Gujarat was actually shifted from there. The Gir forest, they were actually shifted from there to some other national park. They are asking which is that national park. So it will be somewhere near only. It won't shift from, say, Gujarat to Tamil Nadu and all. They won't shift, right? So they will be something near. So if you know the locations, like Corbett is in Uttarakhand, Kunopalpur wildlife is in Madhya Pradesh, Madhumala is in Tamil Nadu, Sariska is in Rajasthan. So possible chances are B or D. Okay, either Rajasthan they will move or either Madhya Pradesh they will move. If you have read it, it is actually Kunopalpur Wildlife Sanctuary. Okay, 95 is B. Now, which of the following is not necessarily the consequence of the proclamation of President's rule in the state? So President's rule was in news because of Arunachal Pradesh President's rule. Okay, so same thing we saw, like different other questions also, election commission because of Samajwadi Party issues. That is what I told. Whatever happens in news, immediately go and read the chapter related to that in Lakshmikant. Okay, immediately you can assure marks. Okay, so statements, you have to tell which is not necessarily, okay, which is not true. So dissolution of the state legislative assembly, removal of the council of ministers, dissolution of the local bodies. So if you know that Arunachal Pradesh issue itself, you will know like that time Council of Ministers was actually removed. Okay, so two you cannot tell it as not. Okay, so two you have to eliminate. So two, if you eliminate itself, you got the answer actually. A you can eliminate, C you can eliminate, D you can eliminate. Option is 1 and 3. That means 1 and 3 need not be necessarily done. That is dissolution of the state. The state assembly need not be fully dissolved. Okay, only the ministers will be suspended. So it's a suspension happening and not dissolution. Then dissolution of the local bodies. Okay, local bodies is something else. So both 1 and 3 are the answer. Not okay. If the not word was not there, then it will be like 2 only or something, but such an option is not there. Okay, so option 1 and 3 B. Which of the following are envisaged by the right against exploitation? It's a direct question about what is article number 24 and 25, I think 23 and 24. Okay, right against exploitation, we know our fundamental rights are classified under different headings. 14 to 18 will be the right to equality. Then next will be right of freedom. Then there will be right against exploitation. Then right of freedom of religion. Okay, like that they have classified 5-5 articles or 3-3 articles under different headings. So they're just asking which are the articles under right against exploitation in the Constitution of India. So we know untouchability analysis article 17, which comes under equality. So 2 will not be there. If you eliminate that also, you will get the answer. Then protection of interest of minorities. Minorities again, it will come in the religious freedom. Okay, it will not come in the exploitation part. So the remaining two, the prohibition of traffic in human beings and the prohibition of employment of children in factories and mines. So 1 and 4, option C. It's a very straightforward answer. At least the 32 fundamental rights, fundamental rights, duties, DPSP, preamble. These things are things which no serious aspirant will forget ever. Okay. Next is again a mapping question. Very interesting question. I told islands in Indian Ocean, they'll ask a question. Andaman and Nicobar, another thing. Every year one question will be there with Andaman and Nicobar. Okay. So they are asking Great Nicobar, which is closest to Great Nicobar. Okay, so in the map, if you go and see Indian Ocean, we'll be obviously thinking like it's a part of India and it'll be nearer to Sri Lanka, but it's not the way. Andaman Nicobar is actually a little bit far away from Indian mainland. Okay, and it is closer to you can say the Thailand area, or you can tell the Indonesian area. So Indonesia now next. So if you have reached till there, you can eliminate Sri Lanka. Then you'll be thinking like, okay, whether it's Sumatra or Java. Borneo still, you know, it is the Asian country, ASEAN. Okay, Asian country, and it is a little bit towards the eastern side. But so Sumatra and Java will be confusing. For that you need to know the map of Indonesia. Indonesia, Sumatra is on top, then it is Java, and Borneo will come even east of that. So Sumatra is the closest to Great Nicobar. Okay, so the very interesting question, everybody would not have done it right. So question number 99, again cabinet form of government. They have asked question on democracy, they have asked question on parliamentary form, everything in one single paper. Okay, now cabinet form of government, they're asking what is the principle underlying it. So statements are again close by an arrangement for minimizing the criticism against the government. So do you think such a for criticizing against the government and all, they'll form a body? No, right? So that is wrong, totally wrong thing. A mechanism for speeding up the activities of the government whose responsibilities are increasing day by day. This many students thought this is the answer because cabinet will take decisions quickly and all, but that is not right. Then a mechanism of parliamentary democracy for ensuring collective responsibility of the government to the people. So this is actually a true statement, but we have to see option 4 also. A device for strengthening the hands of the head of the government whose hold over the people is in a state of decline. This is not true. Okay, we will not make someone more powerful and all. So this is wrong. But see, if you see, it is parliamentary democracy. We know from the cabinet mission which happened long back and all, Britain parliamentary form, we took this. So cabinet, actually the word cabinet is nowhere mentioned in the constitution. Okay, that is another fact. But the principle is this thing only, collective responsibility of the government to the people. That is why cabinet is there. Okay, so very close by options, and it is little difficult. Okay, which one of the following is not a feature of Indian federalism? It's a very wonderful question actually. There is an independent judiciary in India. Okay, we know like it's independent judiciary, so there is a separation of power, so that's obviously part of federalism. Okay, so but they are asking not a feature. Okay, the next one, powers have been clearly divided between the center and states. Okay, that's also true. We have the union list, state list, and also that's also part of federalism. The federating units have been given unequal representation in the Rajya Sabha. You know, like big states like Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, and all, they'll have more MPs in Rajya Sabha. But the small state like Sikkim and Goa, they'll have maybe one member or something, one or two. So that is actually true, and that is about true about Indian federalism. Okay, federating units have been given unequal representation. So 1, 2, A, B, C, all are true. So now we have to read the third one. It is a result of, fourth one. It is a result of an agreement between the federating units. So this is actually, we have read this, but it is not Indian federalism, it is US federalism. US, you know, 50 states, they came together and then formed a federation. Okay, that is why USA it is called Federation of States and India it is called Union of States. Okay, there is a difference. India, it is not fully solid federalism, you can tell. It is partial federalism only, okay. Okay, the concept of that indestructible union of indestructible state, that is USA. India, it is destructible states, but indestructible union. Okay, so that concept, they are just testing you, okay, basic thing. So they have asked federalism, they have asked democracy, cabinet, parliament, everything. Polity, I told 24 questions have been asked in 2017. Next year, maybe they'll focus on geography or history or something like this. Okay, this year history was, I think, 14 questions. So we have covered the 100 questions. Any doubts, please ask in comment section. I will make videos for other years also, 2016, 15 and all soon. Give your feedback, only then I will proceed. So till we come up with our next video, thank you and have a nice day.